Okay, hello everyone. In the last two video lectures, I cover under the Open PLC the simple on-off coding, ladder coding, and second we covered with the latching, on-off with the latching. In this video lecture, I'm going to cover under the Open PLC editor timer on delay and timer off delay program. And let's start. To start the new program, what we need to do, we need to click on this plus icon, new, or we can go in the file and create the new. Then it will ask where you want to save. Then, as I said in the last video lecture, always select fresh folder, don't take the used folder, otherwise we will throw the error. So on desktop I will create the new folder and I will give the name as TON, timer on delay. Okay, select this folder and it will ask create a new program. And what kind of language we are using here, I am using the ladder coding. Because of that we need to use LD. If you want, you can rename it the POU name. I will keep as it is and press OK. Now our panel is open where we are creating the ladder coding. Now I will make it very simple, this panel ladder coding. I will use only two variables. First we can say start push button, okay, and one more I will use as a output call directly, y100. This is, we can say start push button, and this one is a output LED, okay, LED fan, whatever, this is output point. Now create the ladder coding. We need to create up for power rail, click it over here and make it as a one power rail. We required one variable that pass the logic x100. Okay, sorry, I think so here I make a mistake over here. The data type I forget to change. Make it base type as a boolean. Here also this one is as a boolean. Otherwise you are not getting this option. Just click it over here again, new contact, click it over here, and now you are getting the variable x100. Might be you will face the same difficulty while you are making the practice. Just keep in mind, change the type boolean, otherwise you will not get the name of all this variable on that particular list. And after that we need to use one output coil, we can say, and the name over here. If you want to, if suppose this variable is not visible, just check the type, what type we are using. If you are not using the boolean, otherwise it will not show any kind of value. Then y100, okay, and I think so. Finally we need to add one more rung over here. It will be the right rung of single ladder, okay. Now click, drag it, click it over here, and drag it, click it over here. But in the center we are using the function timer on delay. That means if I press the push button, after some delay only the output we are getting, otherwise we are not getting any kind of output. For that purpose you need to just go in the library under the standard function block. Various functions are there under that. At the second last, TON, timer on delay function is there. Just click and drag it over here. Just remember, click and drag and release over here, you are getting the function block timer on delay. Total 4 pins are there. This IN is input, Q is output, PT is, we can say, the set time, what time we want to set, and ET is nothing but it will be just check the time, whatever the time we set, whether we achieved or not. Just click and drag the input, and here we will click the output as I said. For the PT, whatever the time we want to send, for that purpose we need to create a variable, create a new variable. Just click it and click over here. Now here we need to add the expression. That expression is nothing but, just listen carefully, the expression is nothing but capital T slash, and enter the time in millisecond. For example, if suppose I want to delay 5 second, then I need to enter 500 and write down ms 5 millisecond and press OK. You can enter in second also, but we will keep a practice entering in milliseconds. Press OK. We are getting this variable, just drag it and put it over here and connect this variable on this side. Now ladder coding is completed. We will run this ladder coding and we'll check whether we are getting any kind of error. Then it's very good, we are not get any kind of error. Now we will debug instance. We need to click over here. Our program is started. And just see, only this part is red. press part is black because output is not reached over here because it is false condition is zero. It will pass the zero. If it is one, that time only it will pass the one. And here timer is zero. Why? Because once it is getting the input, then and only this time will be started over here. And once it reaches 5 seconds, then and only I'm getting the output. For the checking the output, just right click over here and press force 2 and just see the output. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now I'm getting the output. I will right click, make it false, it reset to 0. Again I will right click, make it true. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm getting the output. This is all about the timer on delay. To stop the program, we can click over here, and again we can go the in program from this side. If we are over here, we can't edit anything. To edit, we need to go in program. This is all about the timer on delay. The next video lecture I will explain about the timer of delay also. Okay, hello everyone. In the last video lecture I explained timer on delay, and we come to know that how timer on delays work. Now in this video lecture we will see how to create the ladder coding for timer of delay. Again we will follow the same procedure. First we'll create the new file, new. We need to go in file, new. We need to create a fresh folder. Because of that we are creating the new folder. Don't use already used folder. Always the folder should be empty, otherwise we will throw the error. For timer of delay, we'll write the folder name as timer TOF, timer of delay. Just select this folder. Now it will ask the language, which language we are using. Then here we are using the ladder coding LD. If you want, you can rename the POU name. We will keep as it is. Press OK. Now we are getting the panel where we can create the ladder coding. Again, like a previous case, we are making this code ladder coding simple. We are using only two variables. First variable x100. And in the last video lecture, we made a mistake. We didn't change the type. Then here, just remember, change the base type as a boolean. And second, we need output y100. By default, is taking the boolean. We can write the documentation for the understanding purpose. This is start push button. Okay. And this one we can say the output, and let's say it is LED. Okay, simple, only two variables we are using. For the rung, we can use this one, or as I said in the previous video lecture, we can right click and we can add it, add, and we can add the power rail first, single. Okay, no issue. After that we need to add the power rail contact, and this is a normally open, pass the logi, and the variable name is x100. Okay. After that we need to add the coil, output coil, and it will be y100. Very simple. And again we need to add power rail, it will be right side. Okay, just drag it and we'll keep one properly this part. Okay, this one also we will drag it and make it, but at center, as we did this last video lecture, same way here also we are doing. We need to add one variable, that is with timer of delay. Again we need to gain library standard function blocks. Over here timer of delay is here, just click and drag it and place over here. Then on timer of delay, one variable will be added automatically, TOF, timer of delay. Again 4 pins are there. This one is IN input, just connect with the input. Q is the output, connect over here. And PD is nothing but the variable. We need to add the variable over here, or same way right click, add variable. And the expression, as I said in the last video lecture, t/ make it 5000 millisecond. We can make 3000, 4000, 5000, just I'm taking from my side. You can change the value also, it is also possible. And drag it, please, over here. Now ladder coding is completed for timer of delay. To execute, just press over here, start PLC simulation, cleaning the built directory. After that, it PLC started, that means no error is there. Now we will click on debug instant. Now just see, ladder coding is started over here. Now timer of delay, how timer of delays work. Now see, when I press this true, force true, instantly it will come true, but timer is not started as in the previous case. Timer on delay, as I explained in theory lecture, it will on after certain delay. But timer off delay instantly, at same instant when I press the push button, same instant it will be off, on. But it will take the delay for the off. What does it mean? What I'm saying, just I will right click and make it false. Now just see, timer is started, means after when I press the off, it will take some time and after it will be off. That means it will take delay in off. I hope you are getting what I'm saying. In a timer on delay, it will take delay in on. In timer off delay, it will take delay for the off. Again, we'll perform the same experiment one more time. I will make it true. It reset, and at the same instant when I make it true, at same instant I'm getting the output. But when I make it false, it will take some time to off. Like 5 seconds it will take. Just see, 3, 4, 5, and that time it will be off. That is a basic difference between timer on delay and timer off delay. Just keep a practice, create your own ladder coding for not like a way. It is very simple ladder coding you can use in any ladder coding, and just see whether you are getting similar kind of output or not. If you are in any doubt, you can contact me. Thank you very much. Bye bye. Take care. See you soon.